What's up guys, and Fun Ape here. I can't believe this is my final YouTube video of 2019. I gotta say, this year hasn't been the best one. It's had its ups and downs, but I definitely would say that this hasn't been my greatest year, but I hope that next year will bring forth all sorts of new excitements. Okay, since it's my final episode of the year, I thought I would do a clip from my top 20 favorite YouTube videos of this year. But before I get into it, I have to announce something. One of the clips was actually my Howling English dub cover, and I have to say, all I did was write an English dub for it. I do not own the music. I don't own the song. The one who originally created the song, the band was called Flow, and they wrote it for the Seven Deadly Sins anime. So, shout out to Flow, and shout out to the Seven Deadly Sins creators. I love you lots, and YouTube, please don't copyright me. So, with all that out the way, it's time to get right into the video, and I hope to see you guys in 2020. Okay, now here's where we get into my theory. As I said, I have studied every single Avengers Endgame trailer up until this point, and I've also studied the little clip that they just released very thoroughly, and I think that this is the most likely scenario. So I hope you enjoy what my scenario is. Okay, this is where we start my theory. So, look, I do believe that Pepper Potts is going to steal one of Tony Stark's suits, try to find him by pinpointing the location of his suit, and end up saving them. I don't know how, though, but it's the best I can come up with. But this is where we add a little bit of a twist. So everybody back on Earth is just sitting around planning a plot to end Thanos and bring back all of their loved ones. In order to do so, they're going to need to bring together what is left of the Avengers. They even ask Ant-Man for help. I think they may bring Sharon and into this thing, since I think I saw her practicing some rounds in this training facility. She may occur, she may not, I don't know. But it's most likely that she's going to be involved in some shape or form. Okay, as you can see here, we have all sorts of different tiers. The lowest tier is the worst tier, and the highest tier is the best tier. In the lowest tier possible, which is the worst in my opinion, we have Chikorita, because, to be honest, Chikorita is a poor design, and it doesn't really learn that many great attacks. We also have Popplio because, again, it has a stupid design. It has a really stupid smile. Like, to me, it looks too good-natured for a battle. And we have Snivy because it's so... Well, this design is okay, but I've seen way, way better designs. In D tier, we've got Fennekin because, well, I actually used to like Fennekin. Like, it's kind of cute, but I kind of grew out of it over time. Oshawott's here because, well, it is really entertaining in the anime, I'll give you that, but to be honest with you, it's not that good of a Pokemon. And we've got Rowlet because it's the worst Alola, the second worst Alola starter. Now it's time to get into the top 10. At number 10, we have the Ghost type. Now, Ghost types are quite intriguing to me. Like, they can either be a glass cannon, like Gengar, or they can be really bulky and physically offensive, like Dusknoir, for example. Ghost types are good against two types. They're weak against two types. They have two immunities, and they're also quite good against two other types. Basically, poison and bug type moves will not harm them in the slightest. Like, ghost types can be like the MVP of your team if you know how to use them. And I definitely think that this ghost type that I have picked is one of the best of them all. It's also got a bit of a love-hate relationship. You either love it because of how OP it is, or you either hate it because you it's either the design or getting crushed by it. And I'm obviously talking about Aegislash. Okay, so we're going to start out with Kanto, which is Generation 1. At number 5, we have Arcanine. Now, I definitely really, really liked Arcanine, but I never thought I'd put it in my top 5 Gen 1 Pokemon. Like, when I began to like it was actually when I started using it in Pokemon Black and White 2. That was an epic team, because I don't really think Arcanine is a great candidate for a best team for Black and White 2. It's so powerful, and it learns lots of variety of moves, such as Flamethrower, Flame Wheel, Flare Blitz, Dragon Pulse, Thunder Fang, Solar Beam, and many, many other moves. Plus, it's also really good to use in Fire Red and Leaf Green. I specifically say Fire Red and Leaf Green because in Red, Blue, and Yellow, it wasn't able to get Flamethrower. At number 4, we have used Pokemon that you can't usually get in Diamond, Pearl, and Platinum. Now, I know this idea is a little generic and boring, but I think that this could really, really work. Like, do you remember when Pokemon Platinum had just released and they brought in 60 new Pokemon to the Pokedex? Well, I like to see that, but instead of just adding 60, maybe add like 150 or maybe even 200. Like, that would be really cool. Like, plus, it will expand in our horizons and have these opportunities to use different Pokemon that we couldn't usually use. I think it might be a really, really good idea if we brought some Pokemon from the newer regions, such as Carlos and Alola, and then bring them over to the remakes of Diamond and Pearl.
To win some or hurt some, but I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours. Do, 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 do. Yeah. Well, open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and damn, you're free. Look into your heart and you'll find love, 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 love. Listen to the music of the moment, people dance and sing. We're just one big family, and it's our God-forsaken right to be loved, love, 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 love. When I look back now, I've saw us since I last forever. And if I had the choice, yeah, I'd always wanna be there. Those were the best days of my life. Ain't no use in complaining when you got a job to do. Spend my evenings down at the drive-in, and that's when I met you, yeah. Standing on your mama's porch, you told me that you'd wait forever. Home and you're my end. I knew that it was now or never. Those were the best days of my life. Oh yeah! Back in the summer of 69.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. Yeah, you can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself standing in the Hall of Fame. And the world's gonna know your name, 'cause you burn with the brightest flame.
Funny enough, Alolan Marowak is actually my favourite Alolan form, since I'm not actually too fond of the others. Like, Alolan Muk would probably be my second favourite, but it's still not as powerful as Alolan Marowak. If any of you have played Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon and have faced this Alolan and Marowak, you will know how much of a pain in the ass it is when you have to go against a totem Alolan Marowak. Literally, that thing is holding a thick club, which doubles
it's a tax stat, and then giving it some flame wheel. It's got hex. It's got some other moves. I can't remember them all, but I know, oh, with just the thick club and the flame wheel alone, that can really like put a hole in your team.
When it comes to Lola Marowak's stats, they're pretty decent. We've got 110 defense and 80 attack and special defense. Like, that's pretty good, like considering that it's supposed to be an all-out attacker. But if you give it the thick club that I mentioned, it will then double its attack stat to 80, and it will go up to 160. Like, that is pretty ridiculous if you ask me.
Beata Maria, you know I am a righteous man. Of my virtue I am justly proud. Beata Maria, you know I am so much purer than the common, vulgar, weak, licentious crowd. Then tell me, Maria, why I see her dancing there, why her smouldering eyes still scorch my soul. I feel her, I see her, the sun caught in her raging hair, his butt blazing in the out of control. Like fire, hellfire, this fire in my skin, this burning desire is turning me to sin. It's not my fault, I'm not to blame. It is the gypsy girl, the witch who set this flame. It's not my fault, if in God's plan, he made the devil so much stronger than a man.
Every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me. A million dreams, a million dreams. I think of what the world could be. A vision of one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. A million dreams for the world we're gonna make.
Okay, next up we have Professor Snape.
Mr. Potter, our newest celebrity. You're amazingly like your father, Potter. He too was arrogant, strutting across the castle.
All right, next up we have Malfoy. Bet you loved that, didn't you, Potter? Famous Harry Potter. Can't even go to a bookshop without making the front page. Okay, next we have Voldemort.
I can touch you now.
Harry Potter, the boy who lived. Come to die.
Next up, we have Vernon and Dursley from Harry Potter as well.
I hoped you'd be a little bit more grateful. We've raised you since you were a baby, given the food off our table, even let you have a Dudley second bedroom, or purely out of the goodness of our hearts.
To follow up, we have Barty Crouch Jr.
Get your filthy hands off me, you pathetic little men! Hello, father. Where's my TARDIS?
Give me a sign, take my hand, we'll be fine. Promise I won't let you down. Just know that you don't have to do this alone. Promise I'll never let you down. Cause I know I can treat you better than he can.
feminine girl like you deserves a gentleman. Tell me why I've been wasting time on all your wasted crime when you should be with me instead. I know I can treat you better, better than he can. No, better than he can.
Also, let me know what starter Pokemon you're picking: Grookey, Scorbunny, or Sobble. So, without further ado, let's get into the video. Now, as we all know, we're going to be putting a starter Pokemon on our team, and the ones to choose from are Grookey, Scorbunny, and Sobble. So, I actually decided to go what I usually do and go with the fire starter, and that is Scorbunny. Now, I'm not going to lie to you guys. Once I found out that the fire starter is actually a rabbit, I said right away, that's it, hands down, I'm getting the starter. Because if you didn't, and I'm sure you didn't know this about me, but when I was like 7 or 8, I actually went to this garden center with my family, and we actually came across a rabbit. She was a white-furred, red-eyed dwarf, and we called her Sophie. And believe it or not, Scorbunny kind of reminds me of my rabbit. So I thought right away, hands down, I'm getting this starter. Now, before the starters were actually released, I didn't say to myself, I'm picking the fire starter no matter what. I actually said to myself I would use the one that looked the coolest in its pre-evolution or even its final evolution. And since we don't have the final evolutions or even the middle evolutions, I had to go with Scorbunny because it looks so cute. Like, if I had a Scorbunny, I just want to pick it up and hug it, snuggle it. It's just so, so cute. Plus, I think it might, knock on wood, but I think it might evolve into a fire and fighting type. I'm not certain, but it looks like it's going to evolve into another fire and fighting type. If it does, I really don't mind. If it doesn't, I really don't care. Because I would love to use this starter Pokemon. Like, as soon as I saw it, I knew that this starter Pokemon was the one for me.
Tomorrow morning, I'm going to start a new video, which is called Day in the Life of Parker. And if you didn't know who Parker is, it's this guy. Say hello, Parker.
Say hello.
So I'm guessing you're going to go over like his daily routines, what we do together, and, well, just to show him off a little bit, because I wanted him to be on YouTube more, so I guess I'll see you guys tomorrow morning.
Okay, it's now 8:20 in the morning. I literally just woke up. Parker should be awake by now. He usually waits by the stairs for me to come down, so let's see if that's true today.
There he is. Hello, Parker. Good morning. Good morning, Parker. Oh. Hello.
Oh, let me just zoom out.
Hello. Hello. I know.
As you can see, he really loves his Robert. As you can see here, he really loves fuss and attention.
Don't you, Parker? Yes, you do. Oh, you love fuss and attention. It's your favourite thing in the world. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Well, Parker's already, he had something to eat already. He always gets fed, like, literally, well, when I'm asleep, since my mum goes to work quite early in the morning. Oh, and he's getting off the sofa and wandering somewhere. Let's go see where he's going.
Who's made a mess, Parker? Hey? Who's made all this mess? Was it you? Was it you that made all this mess? Was it? Parker? Was it you that made all this mess? Was it?
We're gonna start with
Bloody hell, this isn't... There we go. Okay, this is either going to be Black Griffin or Andrea Bocelli.
Who?
He's a opera singer.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yep.
You have to wait for the entire song to finish.
How long is it?
Only like a minute long. Okay, you're allowed one repeat if you want.
I'm guessing that's Black Griffin.
Incorrect, that's Andrea Bocelli.
Oh, fair, okay.
Okay, this one will be something that you'll like and something you know.
Okay. That's Black Griffin, that's not Michael.
How did you know?
That's not Michael. See, Michael has a very high-pitched tone. That was too deep for Michael, and the beat was a bit slower to Billie Jean.
Okay, so, that's a one and at two, so you got 1 point. Okay, let's go with something a little bit harder. This is either going to be Black Griffin or Eminem. So, what's your answer?
Eminem?
Nope, it's Black Griffin.
I don't know the difference. I couldn't hear what you're saying, to be fair.
Next up, we have Gaston.
Why, hello there, Belle. Don't you think it would be such an honour to marry me?
Next up, we have LeFou.
If we hold her father hostage, she'll do anything to get him back, including marry him.
Next up, we have Doug.
My name is Doug. I have just met you, and I love you. My master made me this collar. He's a very kind and smart master and squirrel!
Are you satisfied? Just open your eyes. You can see the light across this new borderline. We believe that we were gods. We could do what we want. But even God can't be taught a thing or two. Just cause you're undefeated don't mean that you're superior. Someone will come around and knock you to the ground. Hey, get low. Hey, how whoa. There's always someone out there. Hey, you are gonna be somebody. That don't mean that you should quit. You must never become a crier, even when the situation's dire, or when the battle's on the wire. Whatever may come, yeah, you must learn to become a master. Guaranteed to block out all the liars. Move faster than a gunfire. Unleash all the strength that you've acquired, and you will surpass, yeah. Caring to fight the cold, and you'll be purer than gold. I'm howling out for my soul.
Alright guys, so my strategy is to take all the fillings out of the hot dog and mix it in with the fries, so that way it will go down easier. Then I cut open into the hot dog and then use this ketchup, so that way it will be able to go down a lot easier. That's my strategy so far, but I'm not sure if it's going to work. But we can always give it a go. And then the last bit is to chug down this milkshake. The chili is very, very nice, I must say. Okay. Very
10 minutes into the challenge. I've already taken apart two-thirds of the hot dog. It's very, very delicious, very flavorful, but very, very difficult. Like I got my music to keep me distracted. I'm probably gonna take some breaks in between, but we'll see how it goes.